हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक दैट इज द इम्पॉर्टेंट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक और इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ डिफरेंट बायो पेस्टिसाइड्स. फॉर एग्जांपल, द एंटोमोपैथोजेनिक फंगस लाइक वर्टिसिलियम, देन पैसोलोमाइसिस, देन हिरसुटेला, ओके, सो मेटराइजियम. सो डिफरेंट एंटोमोपैथोजेनिक फंगस, the characteristic of each and every entomopathogenic fungus we have to discuss in that topic. So let us see first the importance of verticillium or important characteristics of verticillium. So first one is the verticillium is entomopathogenic fungi. That means what? That verticillium is a fungus that control the insect. So that's why it is an entomopathogenic fungi. Next, the colonies of verticillium grow moderately or rapidly. So verticillium is a fungus that if the favorable condition is arises or moist condition is arises, so the verticillium fungus multiply rapidly. That fungus is known as white halo fungus because of the mycelial growth on edge of the infected insect. That means once that verticillium fungus attack on the insect, so once that fungus attack on the insect, then whitish mycelial growth is occurred on the edge of the infected insect. So that's why the white halo fungus or the that picture is just look like the white halo fungus. Then it is effective against all soft body insect like aphids, thrips, mealybugs, whitefly, jacids and scales insect. That means the number of sucking type of insect is controlled with the help of that verticillium. The next, the conidia or the spores of verticillium is a slimy and attached to the cuticle of insect. That means due to the slimy nature of the spores of verticillium, once they attack on the insect, so on the cuticle they quickly attach to the cuticle of insect. It has the ability to permeate across insect cuticle due to the mechanical pressure and destroying the enzyme. That means that fungus extremely exert the pressure on the cuticle of the insect. Due to that, by breaking the cuticle, that fungus enters inside the body of that insect. And after once they enter, so they neutralize the enzyme which is present inside the body of insect. Then it produces insecticidal toxins called as an bacillolide and dipeptidoglycolic acid. So that toxin, the enzyme which is present inside the insect, it get neutralized. Next, that fungus infect the insect by producing the hyphae from germinating spores that penetrate the insect integument. And the fungus then destroyed the internal contents and the insect dies. That means at the initial stage, what happens? The fungal spores get deposited over the body of insect. Then that spore germinate by producing the germ tube. Then that spores and germ tube exert the pressure on the cuticle of insect. And due to the extreme pressure, that cuticle get breakdown and that fungus get enters inside the body, and due to that the internal content of that insect it get destroyed. The next, the fungus eventually grows out throughout the cuticle and sporulate on the outside of the body. That means once the fungus enters inside the body of that fungus, so inside the body of the fungus that fungus gets sporulate. It has also covered the outer surface of the body of insect. The next one is importance of metarhizium. Here, that metarhizium, it infects over 200 insect species. That means near about 200 insect is controlled with the help of metarhizium, because as the biological insecticide to control the number of pest. For example, the termites and thrips is effectively controlled by the metarhizium. It is used to control the malaria transmitting mosquitoes also. Then metarhizium species does not infect the humans, so that it is beneficial or it does not having any harmful effect on the human body. The microscopic spores are typically spread on the affected areas. That means if you we have to prepare the spore suspension of such a fungus, and that spore suspension is applied where the infected area is there. So automatically it minimizes the population of the thrips also. Then it causes diseases in various insects by acting as a parasitoid. It is a mitosporic fungus with asexual reproduction. Okay, so this is very simple characteristics. The next, the importance of Beveria. As we know that Beveria bassiana, it can be used as a biological insecticide against the number of pests such as termites, white flies and many other insects also. So it is very beneficial because as we know that termites that causes heavy loss once they attack on the crop. Then it is used to control the malaria transmitting mosquitoes, just like in Metarhizium. As an insecticide, the spores are spread on affected crops as a emulsified suspension or wettable powder. Then that species, it parasitizes a wide range of arthropod host. Then it rarely infect the humans, not the ant or other animals. That means it does not infect the humans as well as animals, so that it is considered as a safe insecticide. It does not cause any harm to the human and animals. Then Beveria bassiana was implicated in causing a pulmonary disease inability to exhale normally, which causes difficulty breathing. Then a slow moving typically herbivorous land reptiles, it also controls. Then this fungus is 100% effective in eliminating the bed bugs. That is, it is effectively controlled for the bed bugs. Then importance of Pneumoria fungus. It is entomopathogenic fungi which shows the potential control the insect pest in nocturnal habit. That means those insect which belongs to family Noctuidae. That means that insect is mostly seen in the night stages or in night, or the infestation is mostly takes place in at night. It is effective against Helicoverpa armigera or Spodoptera leutera, etc. That is called as the nocturnal habitat, or that insect having a nocturnal habitat. It has potential to form a mycoinsecticide which acts as a toxin. That means once they infect the insect, so it produces the toxin, and due to the toxic nature, or due to the toxic substance which is secreted by that Pneumoria, the death of that Helicoverpa and Spodoptera is takes place. That the insect belongings to Lepidoptera is mostly controlled with the help of Pneumoria. The host specificity of the Pneumoria, and it is eco-friendly nature, it that encourages its use in pest management. Then it has been reported that toxic effect of Pneumoria micellar extract on Helionthus C or Helicoverpa virescens. Here the picture is seen here that Spodoptera is get controlled due to the fungus Pneumoria. Then last one is important of Bacillomyces. How that Bacillomyces controls, regarding the important characteristic that Bacillomyces is a genus of fungi and most of the species in this fungi are plant pathogens. Okay. Then that Bacillomyces is capable of parasitizing the nematodes' eggs of the horticultural crops. That means that Bacillomyces is effectively controlled for the nematodes which is present in soil. Then that Bacillomyces is cosmopolitan filamentous fungus which inhibit the soil decaying plants and food products. Then it protects the root system against the disease caused by the plant parasitic nematodes. As we discuss here, as we know that the nematodes directly attack on the roots of the different plants, due to that the entire plant will become die. But due to the application of that Fasciolomyces. What happens? That plant parasitic nematodes get control, or intensity of that such a nematode is controlled. That Fasciolomyces is commonly soil saprophyte and a facultative parasite fungus, attacking the sedimentary stages of nematode. It destroyed up to 90% of the eggs and 75% or 80% egg masses of cyst nematode. Then it acting in decomposing the raw organic substances and solubilizing the phosphorus. That means that fungus do not control the insect, but also it decompose the raw organic substances, and it also help for the solubilization of phosphorus. That eliminate the use of costly and harmful chemicals, and due to that it having a zero residual toxicity. It does not leads to development of resistance in the plant pathogens. So this is one of the most important advantages of such a fungus. And then last one is importance of Hirsutella thomsoni. So how it looks, just like this Hirsutella, that fungus, that picture indicate, the middle picture indicate the insect is completely covered by the whitish micelle fungus. Due to that, the death of insect is takes place. So let us see here, it is used for the control of citrus rust mite. This fungus is also pathogenic to the order which belongs, or the insect that belongs to order Acarida or Lepidoptera or Hemiptera group of insects. That Hirsutella genus control the most important pathogen of Eriophyte mites. As we know that the sterility mosaic of pigeon pea or tur is transmitted by the Eriophyte mites, but due to the Hirsutella fungus, that Eriophyte mites control, and it is likely represent an important cause of mortality and extinction in the mite community. Then it is also used as a mycoacaricides for the coconut mites. That is, coconut mite is also controlled. Then it is non-toxic and no residual activity, that it does not produce any kind of residual action. Then it eliminating the use of costly and harmful chemicals that we already discussed. So this is the characteristics of the Metarhizium fasciolomyces, then Hirsutella, Nemuria. Okay, so all are called as an entomopathogenic fungus, it having the important characteristics. So if you have any difficulty regarding that, the important characteristics of the entomopathogenic fungus, so you can message me or WhatsApp me. Thank you.